discussions. Marco.
Okay. So thank you very much, first of all, for inviting me here. I'm coming from a different background from, I believe, many of you. I'm an IT guy. I worked in IT for more than 20 years. But I'm also a parent of a dyslexic child. And when 3 years ago I found out that my older son was dyslexic, I didn't know anything about what was dyslexia and specific learning disabilities. So I researched a bit and I decided to develop some apps for my own child. Because I had the impression that the tools that were available on the market, especially in Italy, were not good enough, in my opinion, to support a younger kid as my kid was at that time. He was 9 years old. So I developed those apps and I was lucky enough to meet very good specialists that were following my son, speech therapist and psychologist, who encouraged me to, when they saw my apps, they encouraged me to further enhance them, and I decided to build a company, a startup, to develop a tablet to support those kids. So I did that, and this was 2.5 years ago, and I started to share my experience on the internet in Italy and got a lot of questions and requests from people, and in particular I got some requests from the Roman healthcare system, which we call ASL. I am from Milan, so they are a bit far from me, and they asked to go there and show what I had built, and they decided to they proposed me to do a scientific first of all they asked me to get 300 devices for the dyslexic child that were under their area of supervision within Rome. And I was a bit worried about giving something that didn't have yet a full scientific support and evaluation. So I proposed them do a scientific trial of the tablets. So I would have given them the tablets and we would have started a trial with all those kids to verify scientifically if the tablet was effective and to gather also possible improvement opportunities from the experimentation. So we found we did some fundraising to ensure that we were able to provide 300 tablets, which was a big expense for a self-funded company as mine. And we started this test. So today I will show you the results of this 2 years testing activity, the background, the methodology that we use, and the results that we got. For the record, the tablet is an Android tablet. Provide both hardware and software bundled because we do some customization that we will see if there is time later. I have the device here, by the way, if you want to see later. And we do some customization both in terms of providing high readability fonts on the tablet to replace the text-to-speech voice with one that sounds better in Italian, because it might sound good, the text-to-speech in English, the standard one, but the Italian one is terrible. It's better to, there are good ones, commercial ones that you need to load. So in practice, we provide the device with hardware and software, so it's just a plug-and-place device that families can use. Okay, so I won't spend that much time on dyslexia, just say that is a neurodiversity of people that create big difficulties in them in reading or writing or performing calculation or all the three, and that is not related to IQ, so those kids are as intelligent as the others, or even more sometimes, but they make a lot of effort to perform those simple activities such as reading. So the effort that they do, takes out strength to them to perform other activities, like, for example, comprehension of a text that they are reading. So, in Italy, in general, and I mean, I will talk about Italy, but I believe it is it applies everywhere in Europe. Kids with dyslexia or specific learning disabilities are entitled by law to have some help to perform some activity and to have some special education. Basically, in Italy, Italy was late in adopting a law on this element, on this aspect. We adopted a law in 2010, and with this law, kids need to be certified by a medical committee, which is composed by speech therapists, psychologists, and neuropsychiatric, who assess that the kid is has specific learning disabilities. Once it is certified, he will do some activities with the specialist, some therapies that will help them to catch up to their neurodiversity, up to the level that their neurodiversity allows them, and in parallel they can start use compensatory systems at schools to perform those activities that are complex to them. Those tools could be both some schemas, some papers that they help them to, you know, remember things, or tools to read, like computers with text-to-speech capabilities, or, of course, tablets. Okay. The background, when I decided to develop application for the tablet, I was coming from this background, from this experience, which is what also the Italian healthcare system confirms us, which is that younger children find quite difficult to use traditional assistive technologies on PCs, because they need to have coordination with eye and hands, mouse, keyboard, know the file system, find the file that they need to open. Sometimes the PCs hang up or get viruses. They are quite powerful tools, PCs, so they can also distract them, because they have a lot of things that the kids can do. There are a lot of things that kids can do on the tablets, on the PCs, so it is, could be also a distracting thing. And sometimes special learning disabilities comes also in combination with ADHD, or in general, younger kids tend to be distracted quite easily. Sometimes they feel the PCs as a differentiating factor, which is a negative differentiating factor, as you were as opposite to the tablets. So they see it as a medical, wheelchair or something that differentiate kids in a negative way. So they don't want to use it at school, or they resist, let's say, to use it at school. In Italy, not all the teachers are IT aware or have familiarity with PCs, and sometimes even they don't feel that there is part of their job to assist the kids with the computer. If they have issues with the computer, it's their business. It's not the teacher business. The teacher business is teaching, you know, front-facing lesson to the class. Not necessary. Not all the teachers, of course. I'm saying there are some
Most
teachers.
Of them.
Some of them. Furthermore, PC are not optimized as they as out of the box for readability by default. Text-to-speech libraries, default text-to-speech libraries, at least in Italians, are terrible the way they sound. And fonts on PCs by default are small and not necessarily very good to read. Additionally, I see very similarity with the experience in UK, also the cost for PCs is very high. When we started this project, the local healthcare system calculated that the cost for kids to use a PC with assistive technology on board is around 2,000 euros for elementary school and secondary school, including hardware, software, and possible issues they might have, like viruses that need to force them to reinstall things and so on. While instead we were able to provide a tablet at the cost of the tablets that are on the market right now, but with all the tools that they use to study. We will come back later to this aspect, the loss of self-esteem in the primary school for kids with special learning disability. It might then push them to believe that they are not you know, intelligent enough and generate you know, in the worst case, a burnout that don't you know, proceed with the you know, school process, or in general choose a kind of school that is lower than his or her capabilities, intellectual capabilities. Okay, this I already described you, the background of our tablet. Let me show just a couple of things. So our tablet is called EDITouch, started as a personal project. And when we designed the tablet, we worked with a speech therapist and a psychologist to shape the features and also to determine the roadmap of the applications. Also, we collected the feedback from the parents. So, in Rome, where we started this project, the situation, we did this project in an area of Rome which is not one of the richest area of Rome. So there was some social economical situations where people were not only from economic perspective but also from cultural perspective from the family not followed that much from them, and in that area it was lacking a proper connection between what the family were doing at home with kids, supporting them for school activities, the school itself and the teachers. And also it was lacking a link to the social, to the healthcare system, which in Italy is one of the entity that can certify the dyslexia of the kids. So the process in Italy starts like the school says that the kids have some difficulties, they stay in line with the healthcare system to get you know, an appointment in 1 or 2 years to get visited, and then they are certified, and then they are allowed to be to use some tools at school. So in Rome, all those three areas and activities were separated. So Additionally, as I said, there was a high cost of buying computers for the family. So all of these aspects were a barrier for those kids, for many of those kids to use assistive technology. Additionally, the ASL that did the scientific research found out that only 25% of the kids that bought the commercial software for PCs in Italy continued to use it after 6 months after 6 months since they bought it, because there is a very high curve, learning curve that the kids need to pass through to start to use them, and many of them abandon the effort after a few attempts. So in the years 2012 to up to 2014, we with a team composed by doctors, nurses, speech therapists, psychologists from ASL Roma D, which is the Italian healthcare system of Rome, together with some researchers in the University of L'Aquila and the University of Rome, and together with some IT guys working with me, we conducted this test, training teachers, both teachers, parents, and kids to use the tablets at school, at home, in the same way. So we ensured that they were able to work, as said, in the same way with their homework and with the school activities. So the purpose of the trial was to evaluate scientifically the effectiveness of the tablet and compare it to the existing tools, and also to find the possible improvement opportunities for the software. Okay, this eventually I will tell you later are some data on the issues that we have in the school system, like the number of dropouts compared to the European ones, and the issues that they can generate, and the cost for the society that they can generate a 1 year lost for school rejection for those kids, but I will come to this later if there is time. Okay, so the methodology, I won't go, I will summarize this a bit. So we did a scientific trial on 400 kids aged between 9 and 16 years, in which there was a group A, the target group, which was composed by SLD kids, and where they were 219. Then there was a group B of and were the one who received the tablet and used for the full length of the trial. Then there was a group B, a control group, which was composed by 150 kids, 100 with SLD and 50 without, who did their own activities. The one with the SLD used different school, and the ones without, they have been given the tablet to ensure that there was not a sort of placebo effect, with only the fact that they had the tablet made them more motivated and working better. And then we did we evaluated these kids with an ABA test, meaning we performed some tests upfront, psychological tests. The neuropsychiatric did the psychological test. I don't know if you are familiar with them. They did the SAFA, the CBCL, and all those tests for evaluating the psychological status of the kids. We did some questionnaire on teachers to understand the kids' school situation. And so we did those tests at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end of the trial. Okay, so some information on the target group. So as we said, we have 219 SLD kids. The age of the kids is represented in that pie chart. So basically, they were the most of them was at the Italian secondary school, which runs from 11 to 13 years old. And there were a lot of them also in the primary school. Primary school in Italy starts at 6 years old. We have here 9 years old to 10 because the dyslexia certification in Italy can be given only after the completion of the third grade. So that's why we included those kids. And we had also some students from high school, fewer of them, but we have some students also from high school. The gender split is near what we record in general for dyslexia in Italy because there is generally a bigger number in boys than in male than female. On average, we had 3 SLD per class, which is a bit higher than what we generally experience in Italy. So we had a higher concentration in that area of Rome. And 43% of those kids already had used other assistive technology, other compensatory tools, software basically on PCs. And the 56% no. And the one that were that they already use it, they said that they rejected it because it was too complex and they didn't it took too time for them to use them compared to what to the goal that they wanted to reach. So I have here a slide also on the teacher involved in the project. We had 80 teachers in 8 schools involved in the project. Basically, the most of them was over 40, and we asked them to do a self-evaluation, giving themselves a score from 1 to 10 about previous awareness of dyslexia, about previous knowledge of computer technology, and about their ability to perform an inclusive teaching involving all the class, not only in the same way, not only the normal reader, but also the students with dyslexia. So as you see, they didn't have that much previous knowledge of computer. They gave themselves 6, which to me, okay, and ability to perform some. No, yeah, okay. And the split of school between primary and secondary school teachers involved in the project. Okay, let's come to the result. So we taught to these kids a new studying method based on the tablet. The tablet was their primary studying tools. They had all their books and all their activity on the tablets. And so these graphs show the outcome of the battery of test on the liking of the study. The average mark for students was 9.11 from a 1 to 10 scale. Teachers said 8.21, which is an achievement to me because it was a completely new things for them. I mean, we somehow forced them to, adopt a new way of teaching to kids, and they liked it. And also parents gave us a very good score. To confirm the liking of the studying method, we asked the kids if they wanted to use the tablets more. And they said that they wanted to use it more at school because, unluckily, it was not possible. Not all the teachers supported them perform their activity on the tablets. So even the the overall project was to use to allow them to use that. Some teachers, in a way, they didn't do all the things on the tablet, but the kids wanted to do it. 58% at school, and they also wanted to do it more at home, because they were using it for... there is also a question, I didn't put the graph, but I can share with you, asking them what they liked in the tablet, and you won't believe me if I tell you that they never answer... Few person answered that they liked the tablet to play games. The most of them said that they liked it because it was easier to read, because it was good to make maps, to memorize things, and also for the calculations and so on. Okay, some information about the evaluation on psychological improvement. So the battery of tests shown that according to parent judgment, kids had 73% of the parents said that the kids had a greater autonomy in performing their own activities. Remember that dyslexic kids generally, when they are at home, are often, no, generally maybe not, but they are often supported by the mom or the dad who reads for them the books, so that they concentrate on the understanding. So now they became more autonomous and had a greater peace, less stressed, basically, which is also what the teachers said at school, because some of those kids were saying to the parents Monday morning that they had stomachache, headache, was not possible to go at school, and so in a greater way that what generally kids do anyway. Okay, so also the teachers confirm this information. Okay, finally, let's go to the evaluation of educational effectiveness. So these are answers from teachers on the educational effectiveness. So teachers said gave a rating from 1 to 10, the average rating from 1 to 10 given by all the teachers on the fact that the tablet allowed them to provide a more inclusive teaching was 7.22. And they wanted to they had intention to use it also after the completion of the project. Finally, an evaluation against the other existing tools, and basically they said that they are simpler, that the EDITouch is simpler, easier, and more effective than the other tools on PC. And this was said by parents, students, and the teachers consistently. What in marketing and in the company is called Net Promoter Score is an important value that shows how a person is willing to support a product, believes in a product. So you ask them questions saying, how much we will recommend this product to other people with your difficulties and so on. And student average score is 8.61. Teachers is 7.79, and parents 8.04. Okay, so the conclusion of this trial was that after those 2 years' activities is that studying with the EDITouch tablet favor a greater results, a greater academic results in students, both from the easier access to the information with the tablet, but also for the higher self-esteem, the autonomy, and the motivation that they gain through the usage of the tablet itself. This was achieved in a short time because, as said, we did a 1 year and a half, 18-month project, and you can consider the first 6 months of time were spent for training was only 1 month and a half. But, to get, used all the teachers, the parents and the kids, even after the training, it took some time. So the first half year was more a tune process. So the specialists believe, or let's say we all hope that this higher achievement that they gained will be consistently kept over the years in future. So basically, this was the results of the research, and I put here also the name of the responsible of the experimentation in the ASL in Rome, and of course my data and the data on the tablet. I don't know if we have time. I have some videos and also some other information on how the software on the tablet works, but up to you.
We're a bit short of time.
Okay, then we will put on the.
Do you have one with you?
I have one with me.
Okay.
Yes, sure. So this is, we have three models, and we have one for primary school, one for secondary school, and one for high school. I will show here, okay, a screenshot of the primary school layout. We modified the launcher, which is the starting application for the tablet, so that a parent or a teacher can selectively choose what app are available to the kid. So we can, and this can depend on the neuro difficulty that the child has, but also to the development process of the child itself, because sometimes you don't provide assistive technology as soon as you find that the kid has difficulties. For example, is dyscalculic, you don't give him the calculators immediately. Sometimes, at least, I mean, our experience in Italy, that the specialist make them do some exercises prior to give them the calculators. So with this interface, which is also available here, kids have access only to the applications that the parents or the teacher select. So this is good also for the exams. So you can selectively choose that during the exam they don't have internet access, or they don't have access to other programs than, for example, the e-book reader or, for example, the calculator. So the teacher is confident that the kid is not playing Angry Birds or is not looking on Wikipedia, the information for the research, but is only using the tools that they select. Then also the fonts is a high readability font. We have on the tablet, there are several high readability font on the market, both open source and commercial. And according to the tablet, we provide them as a standard font, which applies to all the books, all the applications that are there. And we can also increase the space between letters and lines to reduce the crowding effect, which for dyslexia is one of the issues. I mean, there are several theories, but kids with dyslexia are facilitated in reading if you differentiate letters and lines, and also if you use sans serif fonts, so without the I don't know the name in English, but those things at the end of the letters. So basically, this is the interface for the primary school. We have a password protected area where I can configure what the kids has access to. Is PIN protected. The PIN, the disposition of the number is randomly shuffled so that the kid doesn't learn, the pattern that you make, because otherwise they learn it easily. And of course, once they completed their study, you can, for a reward, or for example, because they finished the homework that they can play, you can enable on the tablet that there are also and can be installed some games, because it is the device is an Android device, and of course we buy it and resell it once we install our application. So you have also full access to the Google Play Store, so you can download application, buy games and whatever, in case you need. And okay, several models. I can show you some pictures that the kids, some draws that the kids made. They are in Italian about the tablet, because During the training, we worked also on their awareness of what is their issue. So we showed them movies, for example, there are some great ones that I'm sure you know about what is a dyslexic student, what are the difficulties they have, and so on. So we showed those movies. We asked them questions, what is for them dyslexia. They did sort of coming out, you know, being able to talk about this in the classroom with friends, because we gave them sort of proudness of being dyslexic, because we worked also on famous dyslexic people from our time and from past time, so like Einstein and Leonardo da Vinci in past, Mika, Tom Cruise currently, you know. So you can give some boost to kids, you know, saying that, you know, also successful people, and that they like. So they made also some, you know, advertising, no tablet, no party, or some suggestion for me to improve, you know, the tablet. They described their history. This is very nice. Is in Italian, but each of them described what was the issue in previous school and so on. And okay, some other motto, from ABC to PC, with the tablet you can make it. And I have comments from parents and from teachers on this.
Excellent, thank you very much.
Difficulties do you face at school or in the free time?
In the free time I have no problem. I like reading, but I prefer reading books with big letters.
I can be overcome with the help of me of someone who loves you.
What difficulties do you face at school or in the free time?
I can be a problem when learning by heart. I'm tired and in a difficult moment.
What is for you dyslexia?
It is when you have a difficulty in reading, working, meeting calculation.
What difficulties do you face at school or in the free time?
At school I have some difficulties in the writing because I don't work, make me stand.
What is for you dyslexia?
It's a burden.
What did you like about the project?
It was nice to have several problems in the SAM class, so we cooperative, and the touch arms are very easy.
What difficulties do you face at school?
At school, I don't like reading and writing. I am always instructed.
What did you find useful in using EDITouch?
EDITouch is more interesting than book. It is useful to use.
A tutti gli alunni e alla sottoscritta e ai docenti l'uso del tablet. I 14 ragazzi certificati DSA puri hanno usato questo strumento dall'inizio del secondo quadrimestre dello scorso anno scolastico sino al termine, e quest'anno hanno ripreso. L'uso del tablet ha sicuramente aiutato il processo di apprendimento attraverso le immagini e non le parole, perché questa è la caratteristica fondamentale della dislessia. Poi nell'ambito delle offerte che la legge 170 ha dato al territorio, il MIUR ha organizzato un corso universitario, un master al quale mi sono iscritta io, perché essendo partito a maggio non potevo certo pensare che gli insegnanti potessero farlo d'estate, quindi mi sono informata io e ho usato il tablet per la realizzazione dei prodotti didattici della sede centrale. Sicuramente l'esperienza è stata non solo valida dal punto di vista didattico, ma alimentato e potenziato la motivazione allo studio, che in quest'ordine di scuola, la secondaria di primo grado, laddove la dislessia non venga trattata bene a livello di scuola primaria, arriva ad essere un vero e proprio dramma, perché non è tanto il non saper leggere e scrivere, ma tanto il senso di totale inadeguatezza con la quale i bambini ci aiutano, per poter recuperare il quale abbiamo necessità effettiva innanzitutto di potenziare le loro capacità di relazione e poi di motivarli ad un apprendimento che non è fatto tanto per il voto, per la materia, ma deve essere idoneo a dare loro gli strumenti per affrontare la vita. Ecco, in quest'ottica il tablet è davvero uno strumento facilitatore, quindi più che compensativo e dispensativo diventa un alleato da banco. E niente come la presenza del pupazzo rassicura il bambino piccolo e quindi anche il tablet rassicura il ragazzo più grande. Indubbiamente dobbiamo essere preparati a tutti i fenomeni di ordine psicologico che possono intervenire nell'ambito di un'attività comunque differenziata o aiutata con supporti differenti, per cui abbiamo ragazzini che in qualche modo non hanno voluto usare inizialmente il tablet perché pensavano attraverso questo di sentirsi diversi. Poi da un punto di vista pratico operativo, visti i vantaggi, molti dei ragazzi, anche non di SA, giustamente lo stanno usando. Il vero problema del tablet è quello di essere uno strumento in divenire che cresce con le potenzialità del ragazzo e diventerà davvero uno strumento operativo nel momento in cui ogni singolo docente riuscirà a produrre materiali per la classe sulla quale è destinata. Siccome poi siamo tenuti alla personalizzazione dell'insegnamento e quindi assolutamente alla conoscenza degli stili cognitivi di ciascuno, avremo tante programmazioni e tanti materiali quanti sono i ragazzi. Quando avremo costruito questa grande banca dati, questo progetto sarà diventato una consuetudine e quindi i ragazzi davvero arriveranno ad essere più forti e sicuramente più felici, che è il vero problema e il vero obiettivo che noi dobbiamo perseguire come scuola. Sicuramente sono il dottor Santini, il dottor Platirotti, la dottoressa Vilasi per quanto riguarda l'ASL Romani, ma per quanto riguarda questa scuola il dottor Martino, che è l'infermiere che ci ha aiutato e ci ha insegnato a usare il tablet, è stato davvero il veicolo migliore che i ragazzi e i docenti e la sottoscritta hanno potuto trovare, perché ci ha insegnato a usare lo strumento con molta naturalezza, non si è mai imposto, ha fornito passo passo i modi di opportunità d'uso finalizzato alla produzione di prodotti didattici. Questo è l'obiettivo della scuola. L'ASL Romadì in che cosa è stato un supporto formidabile? In questo lavoro, nel momento in cui un ragazzo arriva in quest'ordine di scuola e non ha la certificazione, è sicuramente importante di reperire i pezzi di carta che ci consentono di poterla aiutare in un certo modo, ma la presenza costante di personale specializzato all'interno di una scuola e non sporadico o occasionale è davvero il grosso supporto di cui tutti abbiamo bisogno. Perciò il progetto tablet è andato a legare l'attività costante e quotidiana dei presidi scolastici, che sono così importanti, a quella che è la didattica pratica e la pratica della didattica nelle problematiche che possono arrivare a patologie. La cosa più importante e uno dei risultati che sicuramente, anche se nel breve periodo in cui è stato trattato l'argomento, noi abbiamo notato, è proprio il miglioramento dell'approccio alla diversità d'apprendimento che i ragazzi hanno sentito come naturale. E in questo la presenza del presidio sanitario e degli operatori è sempre stata costante, puntuale ed ha aiutato anche i docenti nel momento in cui la programmazione oppure la modalità con la quale il ragazzo in maniera diversificata a seconda delle materie usava lo strumento poteva diventare problematico, perché nella tendenza a semplificare ad oltranza i contenuti c'è sempre bisogno di un adulto che coordini e amplifichi la modalità con la quale come orizzonte ci si deve porre da un punto di vista di crescita culturale, e questo è il lavoro che si fa nel presidio sanitario. Per cui il lavoro dell'ASL Romadì, a parte l'enorme messa in campo di risorse umane, spirituali, psicologiche, di supporto, è stato validissimo dal momento che si è affiancato agli insegnanti, non è stato un percorso imposto. Il lavoro del tablet, i programmi del tablet, non dimentichiamo che sono partiti da un genitore, e da un genitore che avendo le capacità e avendo un problema ha messo insieme le due cose. Ecco, la presenza nelle scuole dei presidi sanitari parte da un problema, avendo le risorse giuste il problema si supera e si diventa l'un per l'altro risorsa.